The city of New York names a rat czar to combat the Big Apple's growing rodent problem. The current rat population in the city is unknown, but a study in 2014 put the figure at around 2 million. Kathleen Corradi, a former teacher, is the new commanding general, and she's battle-tested. She used to oversee rat mitigation efforts in the city's public schools. Rooting out the rat problem also pays well, with an annual salary ranging from $120,000 to $170,000.
Rat mitigation is more than a quality of life issue. Rats are the symptom of systemic issues, including sanitation, health, housing, and economic justice. You can't just deal with one part of the problem and call it a day. We need system-wide solutions, strong leadership, and an engaged population to join the efforts. That's where I come in. As New York City's first director of rodent mitigation, I will bring a science and systems-based approach to reducing New York City's rat population. With a strong focus on cutting off the food, water, and shelter rats need to survive, and ensure every New Yorker is prepared to take up this mantle in this fight.
The Agriculture Department has reactivated Task Force El Nino to help them properly respond to the effects of the weather phenomenon on rice production. Jervis Manahan on the line with that story. Jervis?
Yes, Ron, the Department of Agriculture has announced that they have reactivated Task Force El Nino in anticipation of its effects in the latter part of 2023. DA Deputy Spokesperson Rex Esto Perez said they did so upon instructions from President Bongbong Marcos Jr., concurrently the Agriculture Secretary. Esto Perez said that the President instructed them to mitigate the effects of El Nino, and their response should be supported by figures, facts, and historical data. Esto Perez highlighted the big role of the National Irrigation Administration, or the NIA, as need for water is paramount when the effect of El Nino starts to be felt. He also said that irrigation is important, but also small water pumping units are equally important for those in need, and that there should not be leakages in water systems. He said that they didn't want to resort to cloud seeding, which is a very expensive response measure. Several bureaus under the agency will be represented in the task force, which was created to ensure rice production will not be affected by the natural phenomenon. Ron.
Jervis Manan with that story. Thanks. Globe Telecom says complaints regarding text fraud have fallen by 90% since the start of SIM registration. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Warren de Guzman. Warren.
Hello, Ron. Globe Telecom says SIM registration is working. In a press conference discussing why the upcoming April 26 deadline for SIM registration must be extended, Globe officials revealed the law has actually been effective in curbing text-based fraud. Eric Tambalco, vice president for Globe's mobile prepaid business, revealed that since SIM registration began on December 27, 2022, they have noted some significant changes.
We're feeling it and we're getting the sentiments of the public na hindi na ganun karami ang fraud incidences or text scams. But even if we look at the stats of our complaints, and even yung mga complaints na hinahain sa DICT or sa NTC, drastically bumaba siya by 90%. So yes, upon the implementation of the SIM Registration Act, bumaba na or nabawasan na drastically ang mga scams or mga fraudulent activities.
Globe says this should be a compelling reason for the Department of Information and Communications Technology to consider extending the April 26 deadline by 120 days, 4 months, the maximum allowable extension under the law's implementing rules and regulations. Another reason, Globe says only about a third of its 87 million subscribers have registered their SIMs, with the majority of the unregistered being prepaid. Globe says the other two-thirds will be gravely affected if the deadline is not extended, as their SIMs will be deactivated as required by the law. Like Globe, Smart and Dito have also called for a 120-day extension of the SIM registration deadline. All in all, only 39.41% of the over 168 million SIMs in the Philippines have been registered as of April 11, based on NTC data. The three telco players note many subscribers are not registered because they lack the requisite identification or digital literacy to register their SIMs. All three have offered SIM registration online and on-site through their respective assisted registration sites and official outlets. Other problems cited for the poor turnout in SIM registration include poor or less than ideal connectivity in far-flung areas. Globe Group Chief Sustainability and Corporate Communications Officer Yoli Crisanto says there is a need for both private telcos and the government to work together to improve connectivity in remote areas. Meanwhile, the DICT says it has yet to make a decision on the extension. Ron, back to you.
Warren de Guzman with that story. Thanks, Warren.